Tonight, Jeff Bridges and Glenn Close star in a courtroom drama called Jagged Edge. Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson meet for the first time in Young Sherlock Holmes and the Pyramid of Fear. And the Easy Rider rides again as Dennis Hopper pops up in a new film called The American Way. Good evening, and the good news this week is that the old-fashioned mystery thriller makes a most welcome return in the shape of Jagged Edge. It starts, as mystery thriller should, with a masked and black-clad figure committing mayhem in a bedroom with a hunting knife while the rain lashes down outside. And what makes this opening particularly chilling is that the murder itself takes place off-screen, leaving the gory details to the audience's own imagination. Much, much more effective than having a screen awash with lashings of tomato ketchup. Now then, the victim is an immensely rich young woman, and the question, of course, is who done it? The police and District Attorney Peter Coyote have no doubts at all. They think it was her husband, the penniless Jeff Bridges.
No evidence of any real sexual pattern, apart from the specific wounds we found on the wife. The knife used was a heavy blade, 6 inches long, with a serrated upper edge.
I'm betting a hunting knife. The rope you could buy at any Safeway. There were no prints found, except Forrester's, his wife's, and the maid's. The blood on Forrester's clothes was that of the wife's, but not the maid's.
Head wound.
No concussion. Some bleeding. Blunt object.
Come on, Al. You know what I'm asking you.
Possibly. Self-inflicted.
Got it. Everything was in her name. The corporate stuff, the personal stuff, everything. I mean, she owned the guy. He was an employee, and you know what? He gets it all. Jack Forrester is the direct beneficiary of all of Paige Forrester's corporate and personal assets.
Really think he could have done that to his own wife?
What the hell is that, Al? You murder your wife to take all the money? That is the oldest crime in the world. Only you're real smart. You want people to say, Jesus, you think he could have done that to his own wife? If I was going to kill my wife, that's the way I'd do it.
Well, put it that way, and things don't look so good for old Jeff. But fortunately, he has a very smart lawyer, Glenn Close, to defend him. Mind you, to begin with, she's not so sure of his innocence either. But you know how it is between lawyer and accused. They start a love affair. Well, I expect the interview rooms in the basement of the Old Bailey are full of lady barristers and their suspected murderer clients humping and grunting away. So anyhow, Miss Close starts to believe in Mr. Bridges. But for a long time, she's the only one.
Were you faithful to her?
You know how many times Krasny asked me that? Yes, I was faithful to her. Except for a short period a long time ago. Wasn't even an affair, really. It was like a series of one-night stands. Girl went back to France. Didn't even last a month.
You'll have to tell me all about her.
Yeah, I'll send you all the details. Times, dates, restaurants. You want the motel room numbers? I may have forgotten those. You're divorced, aren't you?
Yeah.
Were you faithful to him? Really?
Really? Was she faithful to you?
Yeah, as far as I know.
What does that mean?
It means as far as I know. I didn't kill her.
I know you didn't.
No, you don't. You just want to get closer to have a better look.
Now, as the witnesses testify and new evidence is discovered, suspicion points at him, then away from him, then back towards him again. And even Robert Loggia, the foul-mouthed gumshoe hired to clear Mr. Bridges' name, has his doubts about him. Meanwhile, mysterious anonymous letters turn up, and so do other suspects. But through it all, both in the courtroom and out, the question remains, is Mr. Bridges a killer or not?
Your Honor, we would like to recall Anthony Fabrizi.
Mr. Fabrizi, I'd like to remind you that you are still under oath.
Thank you, Judge.
Mr. Fabrizi, Are you certain beyond any doubt the knife you saw was in locker 122 and not in locker 222?
No, it was in locker 122. I remember because I put it together in my head as I walked away from it that it was Mr. Forrester's.
Where was Mr. Bendix's locker in relationship to Mr. Forrester's?
Well, I was in the row right behind his.
Mr. Fabrizi, does this look like the knife that you saw that day?
No, this one's different.
How is it different?
Well, it was the same kind of knife, all right, but no, this one here is all scratched up in the sides and the handle's all worn.
Mr. Fabrizi, if this knife was brand new and hadn't been used for over a year and a half, would it look like the knife you saw? Could it have been the knife you saw, Mr. Fabrizi? Is it possible, Mr. Fabrizi?
Oh, Jesus Christ, I don't know. Yes, it's just possible.
Your Honor, I would like this knife marked and admitted into evidence as defense exhibit B.
I think the plot will keep you guessing right to the end, thanks to an excellent script by Joe Esterhaz, first-rate direction by Richard Marquand, later of the BBC, and sharp performances by Mr. Bridges and Miss Close, who looks rather like Meryl Streep and tends to act sort of streepishly as well. There's very good support, by the way, from Peter Coyote and especially from Robert Loggia, who's most deservedly won a Best Supporting Actor nomination. Altogether, I would recommend Jagged Edge unreservedly. It's exactly the sort of film they don't make them like anymore. At which point, let's move on to our regular survey of the top 10 films in London.